you're sitting down, just moving packs. Make a bitch who's jumping jacks like she was an acrobat. Got these bitches looking at me crazy because I got face tats. Ooh, drip, drip, drip. I cannot go.
Yo, what is up, you guys? It's your boy Johnny here, back again with another video. It is that time of year again. It is our vacation haul 2018. That's right, where I show off and flex a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Flex all the cool stuff I got during my vacation. This year, we went to Tampa Bay area, St. Petersburg, all of those places. And let me tell you, I found some big money items. Big money items. Now, some items are actually from an auction I won. If you tuned into my last stream, you saw that I won the auction. So we're gonna open those first, and then I'm gonna show you what I got at on vacation. So first, let's open up this auction. You have this box, this big long box. Now you guys probably tell what it is already by my track record. And if you do notice this thing right here under this, right here, let me flip this over. Under this, there's a big item, and that was part of the vacation haul. And I will show you what that is. It's a very rare item, actually. I have not found one online, and I actually got it for a very decent price. Okay, let me go ahead and... Okay, what? I brought my scissors here for a reason, right? All right, let me make sure you don't see my address, even though I blacked it out, but you know, wanna make sure. Let's go ahead and open that. Oh, we got some newspaper, and here we go. Oh, man, all right. So we're gonna go ahead and open this out of the bubble wrap. As you can see, if you haven't noticed, it's a bat. It is a baseball bat. Awesome. Here we go. Let's go ahead and this wasn't even all the, this isn't even the complete haul. This is day one. I will show you day two is gonna be even more crazy. More stuff, big money items. This is just part of it. You know what I'm saying? This is just to tease you guys a little bit. You know what I'm saying? So let's go ahead. Wow. This is actually dope. It is a Pete Rose signed bat, and it says Hit King right there. 4,256 with the authentication card right there. I'm not gonna show the number, but it's right there. This is actually my dad's. He loves Pete Rose. He's been buying stuff from the auction. I'll go ahead and check it out actually. Oh, it's, oh, I thought it was MLB authenticated. What is this? WOF. I don't know what that is, but it's JSA authenticated. And yeah, it's actually a full size. Well, not full size, maybe like a mid-size Louisville Slugger. Right there. See, hey man, you know what they say. If you got it, flaunt it. And that's what I'm doing right now on YouTube. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, Louisville Slugger, Pete Rose bat. I'm gonna keep it over here. I can give it to my dad. Let me not crush the card. Let's go ahead and, oh, no. I don't want to crush this card. There we go. So, go ahead and put it down. Pete Rose bat, very cool item. He actually is planning to do a whole shadow box with a bunch of Pete Rose items and all of that. So I can't wait to see how that actually comes out. I'm gonna leave the bat right there for him. Next, I'm actually gonna open up the second auction win. I was actually looking at an auction, same auction house that sold all of this. They had a Michael Jordan North Carolina Nike Elite signed jersey. The first day was already over $1,000. There was actually a Michael Jordan item that I had a chance to get my hands on. This trip, it was a basketball. I had him, it was like painted almost. And it was him on the Bulls, and then it was like on the same picture. It looks sort of like that, but it was him on the Bulls and then him on the Barons when he played baseball. I loved it, and it was on a basketball. It wasn't signed or anything. $65, but I didn't pull the trigger because the panel, you know how basketball has like different, here, I'll show you guys. See how the basketball has different panels? Imagine this is the panel that is painted on, or these two, because it was actually bigger. It was like these two, the whole panel was coming off of the ball. Like, it looked like somebody tried to super glue it, but it didn't work, so it was coming off. So that's why I didn't buy that. I wanted it, because, you know, I love me some Michael Jordan, but, you know, I don't really like buying items like that all damaged up. If I'm going to buy something, it's going to be in good condition, and that's why I got this. And you guys don't know what this is. you guys are looking at it like, Johnny, what's that big baseball next? I will get to it. For sure, I will get to it. All right, so there's two items in here, not that much. One is for me and one is for my pops. You know, we got that father-son connection on the auction house, man. We both go ham. We got that father-son connection, baby. You got, we're the dynamic duo in those auctions. All right, so let me go ahead and, here we go. Damn, it is actually bigger than I expected. Oh, it's stuck right here. Sticky. Okay. Oh, damn, that is bigger than I expected. So, let me go ahead, here's, sign up for these guys. They have the best auctions, honestly. Great prices on their items. No reserve either. All right, here we go. Number one is for me. Oh, I gotta finesse it out. If you guys tuned in my last stream, you know what it is, so this is no surprise for you. What time are we on? 6 minutes? Not bad. I don't want to make this video super long. All right, here we go. Take it up. Yeah, let's do this. Oh, because it's double bubble wrap. Jesus Christ, these guys are, their packing is amazing. Yeah, they make sure your stuff gets here on time and in one piece. Because, you know, sometimes the post office gets a little crazy. And I've gotten my fair share of packages damaged. Well, one. It was a Dan Marino item. Ah, damn. All right. I'm gonna take this out of here, and oh, I have my scissors. I'm over here with a pair of scissors, and I'm not even using them. Snip. There we go. Oh wow. I need to find a frame for this, and I will. It is the Stolen Base King, Ricky Henderson, with a certificate of authenticity right there. It looks like it's like a contract he signed or something. Because it looks like somebody cut out the piece and put it right there. But I like the photo. So yeah, MLB record, I can't really see what it says. So this is cool because it's already matted, so all I need to do is find a frame for it. Either a ready-made frame, or I'll take it to my frame guy and he'll frame it up for me. But yeah, that's number one, Ricky Henderson signed. Very cool piece indeed. And this is my dad's, which actually is a lot bigger than I expected. You know, keep up with the Pete Rose theme right there. Yeah, September 11, 1985, Pete Rose, when he became the Hit King. Charlie Hustle, MLB record, all-time career hits, three-time World Series champion, stacks of plaques, authentic signatures. It's double certified, actually. One by stacks of plaques and another one by JSA. So if you have doubts about this, nah, it's very authentic. So he's gonna put this along with the jersey, the bat, and whatever else he has. Yeah, P-Rose. Now this is the creme de la creme right here. I'm about to show you. This is the biggest item I got this vacation, and it's probably the biggest item in my whole collection. Let me see. It's definitely bigger than my seats, bigger than any of my frames. Yeah, it's bigger than any of my frames. So that's gonna be the piece de resistance. Well, in height, it's not as big as the Juan Pierre poster. That's probably one of the biggest items in my collection. It's bigger than everything, honestly. This, and I have to put this on the roof. I can't put this on the wall, because I mean, look at the amount of wall space this thing will take up. I gotta take out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 frames to fit it. So I'll put it on the roof. You guys are gonna flip your shit on this. You guys are gonna be like, how in the world did you get your hands on this? And actually, it was at an antique store. At an antique store in Dunedin, Florida. My parents always say Donedin, but I figured out that the pronunciation of the town is Dunedin. It's up in the Tampa area, you know? And I do have some Tampa Bay Rays stuff in here, don't worry about that. They had an entire sports section, stuff of the Buccaneers, the Rays. They had a lot of Rays bobbleheads. They had the Evan Longoria one, but I already have it. You know, the one with they press the button and it has walk-up music. The first thing I saw when I walked in there to that sports section was this. And when I saw the price, I had to get it. I mean, At first, I thought it was like some custom piece, but then I figured out what it's for, and I'll show you guys right here. See, it's a big ball. It says 702. What is it? 8/16/1973. But look who signed it. If you guys don't know who that is, it's Hank Aaron, the true home run king of the MLB. So, I bought it because it had the MLB authentication sticker, so that must mean that it's true. And it's very hard to forge one of those stickers, because I think when you remove it, I think the middle of the circle like comes off and you can't put it on something else. So I looked up the number, see it, what this was. And what this was, that in 2014, it was the 40th anniversary of Hank Aaron's 715 home run. So they had people, and you can look it up on YouTube, there's a video of it. I haven't seen this number on the field, but it was in there somewhere, because it was like, they had 715 people with numbers from 1 to 715. And this was one of the numbers, and I guess Hank Aaron signed it, and they sold it at the Braves store. And how do I know? Because it has the damn sticker on it still. Now, how did it end up down here in Florida? I don't know, but I have not seen one of these online. And I look high, low, middle, everywhere. I cannot find one of these. I got it for less than 100 bucks. I got it for 85 bucks. Well, 90 plus the tax, obviously. But, I mean, it's just crazy. The price that it was for was really good. The Braves store sold it for 100, but I think it's worth a lot more because it's part of a pregame ceremony to honor Hank Aaron and his 715 home runs. So I think it's actually worth a lot more than $100. I could be wrong. That's just my opinion. I mean, I have not found one online. Obviously, the rarest one would be 715 because that's the coveted home run mark. But I got a late number, 702. I don't know if 715 is signed. I don't know who has it, but all I know is I got 702, and this is going on the roof of my room. This is going to be the first thing you see when you walk in. Just not hanging, I'm going to have it like this way, like, you know, stuck up on the roof. But yeah, Hank Aaron, 702nd home run, signed, pregame ceremony signed. So that's the creme de la creme. Now time to, you know, go down a bit. I went to the George Steinbrenner Stadium in Tampa, and this thing is stuck on my phone charger. There we go. And I actually got this bag at a raffle, the Tampa Bay Tarpons. They're actually playing against the Dunedin Blue Jays. And speaking of them, one of their bullpen coach tossed me this ball. It says Florida League Baseball. You can barely see it. And it has a minor league logo right there. Actually, that stadium doesn't get full at all because it's just like the local people that go. Now, obviously, when the Yankees go to spring training, that shit's gonna be through the roof. But yeah, I got another ball. Probably gonna put it up somewhere. I might have to make a new Tampa Bay. Well, that's my Ricky Henderson. A new Tampa Bay section in my room because I have so much Tampa Bay stuff. I got this. Now, there was two of these. Oh yeah, and here are the tickets for the game. We didn't even stay for the game. We just wanted to go in the stadium. I really didn't care for this. Plus, we had to go anyways, so. Yeah, three tickets to the Tampa Tarpons versus the Dunedin Blue Jays at Steinbrenner Field. The stadium is super nice. I hate the Yankees, obviously. You know I hate the Yankees, but a goddamn passion. And if you follow me on Snapchat, I took a picture of me giving the middle finger to the big Yankees logo on the entrance. So, yeah, I hate the Yankees. I actually filmed a video of me crying on a wall that had Giancarlo Stanton.
Go back! Go back! Why? Why did it stand? Please come back, my man.
But I also got this. This is pretty cool. My dad has one of these, but it's bigger. It's dirt from Mariano Rivera's last season. Now, I know I hate the Yankees, but I respect the legends of the game. I have a lot of respect for Mariano Rivera, the greatest closer this game has ever seen. And it's authenticated by Steiner Sports. They authenticate a lot of New York stuff. A lot of Giants, Yankees, all of that nonsense. So let me open it up, show you. It's MLB authenticated. There's actually another one that it was a piece of Gary Sanchez's jersey. I didn't buy that one, but my dad actually got it because he's a diehard Yankees fan. I fucking hate the Yankees. Gary Sanchez, he's a great player, but I don't know. He's not on the same level as Mo. Come on, man, this is Mo. So I'm probably gonna put this on the wall. You see it says Mariano Rivera's last season, and it's MLB authenticated with the dirt. He's got one of these, a Derek Jeter from his last season, but it's a lot bigger. It's like an 8x10 almost. This is like a little tiny plaque. $25 actually at the stadium. Not bad. So yeah, not bad at all. Mo, last season. And these last two pieces, I actually found them at another antique store. It's, let me go ahead and show you. There's three pieces in here. Yes, they are newspapers, but you'll see why it's so special. And by the way, cheap plug right here. If you're ever in the Dunedin area, please visit this. Penny Lane, Beatles Museum. Beatles is one of my favorite bands of all time. They have the craziest Beatles collection I've ever seen. Like no museum can, maybe a museum in London that I haven't heard of, but no museum can top what these guys have. This guy literally has John Lennon's glasses, like he has them on display, and he has so much Beatles stuff. It's ridiculous. So yeah, if you're ever in the area, visit Penny Lane Beatles Museum. If you like rock in general, man, you know, the Beatles music in general, hell, music. If you like music, you gotta go to Penny Lane, because the Beatles, they changed music forever. So here we go. We got this. I really like this logo. That's why I got it. The old Tampa Bay. It's a piggy bank. It's like a little plastic bank. It's like, I think, like $7. So yeah, I was actually looking for a lot of sports stuff. And then this is where this comes into play. I was looking for a lot of sports stuff, and all of a sudden I see a stack of papers and magazines and old magazines. And I stumble upon this. There's actually two parts of it, and I got both parts. I don't know if you guys, well, no, I'll show you what it says. 5:05 p.m. today, Detroit Tigers versus Tampa Bay Devil Rays, Tropicana Field, St. Petersburg. This is actually St. Petersburg Times coverage of the very first game of the Tampa Bay Rays. The first game. The very first game that they ever played at Tropicana Field, this was the newspaper that came out. I don't know if I'm going to keep it in the bag. I'm debating. I might actually just take it out and put it like in a case. They see right here. I'm not going to open it up. See right there? It's time. And it's got the clock on the baseball 505 in there. Play ball. You see the old Tampa Bay Devil Rays logo. So yeah, this is great. I have a few of the Marlins' first game, but I've never stumbled upon a Rays' first game newspaper. I might actually keep it in the bag, to be honest with you, because I want to preserve this. It still got the sticker. It was $7, 14 for both parts, because I have part two right there, and I'll show you that now. Oh, I don't want this to get stuck, because I don't want this to get ruined. All right, so let me go ahead and put this away. Go ahead and put that there. Tampa Bay Rays. Oh, I haven't gone all the way down. Whatever. I'll fix that later. And here is part two. This one I might actually keep in the bag, because the bag is not that thick. Baseball, dream come true. And people down there love their baseball. I'm going to tell you right now, they love their baseball. They have Kevin Costner here. He wrote a piece for this newspaper. They got the governor, Ron Shelton, Tim Robbins, Suzanne Sarandon, I don't know, and Bob Feller, Cleveland Indians Hall of Famer, right there. I was kind of reading it in the car, and yeah, this is pretty cool. Devil Rays' very first game. I am glad I stumbled upon this paper. That is just awesome. So yeah, guys, this was the Tampa portion of the haul. Then in 2 days, we're taking out a trip to Orlando, to Universal Studios, and I'm gonna really bank out there. Also, guys, before I forget, I want to give a big, big shout out to Iceland. We actually met up out in Tampa. We've been talking for a while, and we actually finally got to meet up in Tampa. She's another YouTuber, and you might have seen her on Comedy Shorts Gamer's video. She's been on a couple of his videos. But, yeah, we've been trying to meet up for a while, because I've been wanting to meet her for a while, and we went to Topgolf and had a really good time. So I'm going to put her YouTube channel in the description. And, yeah, now to the Orlando side of things. Alright, guys, vacation haul, part dos. I might make this two separate videos, or I might just make it one big video. But I don't know. First of all, This is what we got from Universal Orlando Resort. And check out what I got here for riding the ET ride 56 times. By the 18th time, one of the staff members actually gave me this. A passport from the ride. I don't know why it has that hole there. I guess that means that it just doesn't work anymore, or it was one of their extras. I already have this, and I'll show you right here. Let me go ahead, hope if I can take it out. When I went back in December, I accidentally kept mine from the second time I rode it. I had put it in my wallet, and I just framed it up. But yeah, I got a passport. So I'm gonna show you the stuff I bought now. I spent like a lot of money, so yeah. Right here we have an ET towel. I'm actually gonna put this as a curtain for my room, so looks pretty sick. It's got the ship, the moon. I mean, it almost looks like a work of art. Just rolling it up so you can see the rest of it. ET Extraterrestrial Universal Studios Florida. That's number one. Let's switch over from ET to Wizarding World of Harry Potter. I got this. I'm not really a big Potter fan, but I do like this. I've seen Prisoner of Azkaban. My favorite character of all the Harry Potter movies is Sirius Black. There's a couple of these. There's a big poster, but I couldn't get the Sirius one. I had to buy all of them, which means I had to buy Harry, Bellatrix Lestrange, and Sirius. And there's another one too. There's a little frame and there's a shirt. I have too many shirts, so I decided I'm gonna get a notebook and I can write whatever the hell I want here. So yeah, I could write scripts and notes and all of that in here, so that's probably what I'm gonna use. And you know, Gary Oldman, I love him. One of my favorite actors of all time. Not number one, that's Sly Stallone, but Gary Oldman. The only thing I don't like is that you could actually take out this picture and like put something else, but I'm probably gonna tape it on there, but yeah. Gary Oldman. I was actually gonna try to buy Voldemort's wand, but I didn't have enough money for that, but I'm not tripping. I'm not really a big Potter fan, but yeah, Gary Oldman, Sirius Black notebook, love that. Also, from Williams Hollywood Prop Store, I got this. I didn't know it was an actual functioning antique store. I thought it was just a prop store from past rides. A couple of ET trading cards. Not the complete set, but it has like a couple of cards. It has like a good bunch of cards. I think it's like about, I want to say like 20 something of them. So pretty cool. Some of them even have behind the scenes photos from scenes that haven't been seen in the movie. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Here we go. Let's go with the small bag. Here's a brick. You're probably asking, why did you buy a brick? This is a brick from my favorite restaurant, the Monsters Cafe at Universal Studios. So, you see, it's just a brick. A green brick. I think this was on the Frankenstein display. I don't know where exactly it came from, but all I know is it's from the Monsters Cafe. Or it was from the Monsters Cafe, because they have a bunch of these. So, yeah, piece of Universal right here. Piece of history. Next, let's go through the small bag. Here's some paper, random paper. Here we go. Exclusive to Universal Orlando, we got an ET figure. He lights up. Let me press his button. There he is. His heart lights up. It doesn't talk or anything. I'm probably not even going to take him out of the card. I'm probably just going to put him up on the collection. So, ET figure, that's pretty cool. Never mind. But I knew I had to sneeze. Bless myself. Thank myself. But yeah. ET figure. This is actually exclusively to Universal. You see, ET Universal Studios. Exclusive to the ride. So I had to get it. Next we have. Okay. Here we go. Another ET item. A lot of these are ET items. Keychain. I'll probably put a little plush on a key ring. I'll probably put them on my keys. Or something. I just don't want it to break off and get lost, but I'll probably have them. Yeah, ET keyring plush, pretty cool. You've seen the one in the video. It's a bigger one. It has a blue hoodie, literally exactly like this, just small, and a red hoodie. Oh, here we go. ET pen. Yeah, I panked out on the ET store. I hope you know that. And I believe it still writes. I don't know because it was kind of running out of ink. Oh no, it still writes perfectly. Yep, all right, perfect. So, ET pen. Probably use this a lot. Probably have it right on my desk to write shit with. But yeah, no need to explain there. And I'll tell you where it was running out of ink. It was running out of ink here. These are all the tallies from the amount of time that I rode the ride. See, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, and 56 right there. And the staff at the park will verify that I am the record holder. There's that. And anything else in here? Nope, just a bunch of receipts. Yep, just a bunch of receipts. And here we go, creme de la creme. This is, well, one of these things is the creme de la creme. Here's a shirt. You see I got the all around print one, but I actually wanted to buy this one as well, so I got it. I actually have to wash this because I wore this today. I just changed shirts for the video purposes. Here we got a poster, pretty big poster. I thought it'd be a lot smaller, but it's a movie poster. Someday I hope to get this signed by the cast and hopefully Steven Spielberg. That would be awesome. But for now, I'm gonna keep it in this little case. I don't know why it's like stuck to it. There we go. But we took it out. ET. Very good material poster. It's not like paper, is like glossy. So I like that. Let me go ahead and rip this thing off. Oh, cause that. Oh. So this is like stuck on the back of it. Let me rip this off. I'm not gonna hang this anytime soon. So let's go ahead and put that back. I gotta take off the tag too. And this is the original poster. It says ET the Extraterrestrial and his adventures on Earth. Or in his adventures on Earth, sorry. I misread that. Come on. I don't know, it won't go down. But we'll keep it there. I'll fix that later. Here's the creme de la creme. Big ass box. Actually, I had to send all of this to the front of the park to get it so I can pick it up after I finish everything. This is the creme de la creme right here. Big box. I'll show you what it is now. Go ahead and open it up. I haven't opened it. Alright, it's very fragile, so I'm gonna open it up here on the bed. Let me grab my scissors. Right here. I have no clue where I'm gonna put this. It's a lot bigger than I thought. Alright, this was it's not the most expensive item in the ET store. The most expensive item was a replica stunt puppet of ET. Like, it's a big ET, like, huge, and it was like $475. If I had $500, I would buy it, but I did not have $500. And then there's like a plush that's like $80 too. It's like a giant plush, but I don't need that. Would have been good for the video, but no. Alright, so that just takes out. Wow, this is dope. Alright. I mean, I don't want to break this thing. I just, you know, like this. What the hell is stuck on something? It seems like it's stuck on something. No, it's not. I don't want to break any of this. Damn. There we go. There we go. Oh, stuck on the tape. Alright. Check that out. That is dope. Whoa. It's ET hidden in the plush. You can see him right there. And yeah, it's a statue. It was about $95. And I still had money to get the rest of what I wanted. You see it says they're created exclusively for Universal Studios ET. The only way you can get this is at Universal Studios, or I do know they have it at their online store. They sell them online as well. But I got it at the store. So, yeah, they actually had to bring this from another store to the ET store and then back out to the front so I could pick it up when I'm done. It's actually not that big. The box makes it seem like it's ginormous, but I literally can hold it with my hand. So... yeah, there's a couple other statues at Universal are way more expensive than this. This is actually the cheapest. There's one of Marty McFly, Back to the Future with Doc. It was like a 3D poster, like they were popping out. All right, let me put this around here so it doesn't break. I don't know if this is limited. It was $135, but they bumped it down to $95. But yeah, I'm glad they bumped it down because I'm able to buy it now. But yeah, let me go ahead and put this poster down, by the way, before I forget. Oh, come on, I don't want to crease it. Hopefully someday I get this signed by the cast. That would be amazing. There it is. So yeah, I don't think I got anything else. Not that I'm aware of, at least. But yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the haul. That was Universal Studios / Islands of Adventure haul. And yeah, soon you will be seeing these up in my room. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.